Basta, vedere come. Good morning. Hope you all are maintaining good health, and we are here to assist you in understanding the further topics which you have missed in these corona holidays. Today I will start with unit 5. It's the last chapter or a last unit of your software engineering subject. The software engineering till date we have studied all right from its basics, the requirement analysis, the need, software modeling, the design, after design and its implementation, and finally comes after the design and implementation, the last phase is the software testing. In case of software testing, the key concept here we have to make out why the testing is required. What's the need of testing? What's the main reason we are testing the software is our important concept. In that wording or saying why the software is required, it is not to find out the mistakes in the software. It's not find out the mistakes in the software or its design or how it is implemented, but instead it is finding out the errors after implementation the software will commit, that is based on its functionalities, what are implemented inside the software. The software is going to be making, or we predict there may be some errors here or there which have left out maybe by a programmer or by its monitorer, or maybe it's the project manager, or somewhere the software is having some deviations or some errors in the final results. So in such case, how the software has to be tested is a main concern of our worry. In this software testing, of course, this software testing itself as a unit 5 is not sufficient for studying all the testing methodologies in the industry as such nowadays, or right from its origin till date. It's not sufficient, but an overview or a small part, or just an, I can say, giving a information about what you mean by a software testing and what for it is required and how here or there one or the other method that will help you to understand the software testing in your unit 4 as such, that is project management. How you have done a project and how it can be tested against the implementation. For that reason, as per the topics listed, the topic 1, that is development testing. The second one is test driven development. Fourth one is release testing, and the user testing are the main objectives of the study in this fifth unit of your syllabus. This is actually the topic taken from the textbook Somerville, your textbook. Also, some here or there are some references of the Roger Pressman, the reference book. You can go through the topics dealt and the expression or the explanation I have done, and how you can understand. If you have any difficulties in understanding, let me know, either on our the common media, the WhatsApp, or through telephonic conversations, or any the email or so, you can definitely talk to us for clarifying your difficulties. The topic 1, I will tell you in brief, the development testing. Development testing is once the project decided, started, the software is going to be built or it's under development, phase by phase the development testing has to be done. The development testing will take care of all the individual phases of development and test proceeds for each of its phases. And we'll see in subsequent topics how best the development testing helps for muting or mitigating the errors in the software development. The second one, test-driven development. Based on the tests that we have devised. So means how the software has to respond for a particular processes. Based on that, you are going to develop a particular module, and you have an expected result, and you parallelly check the actual outcome, compare it, and finalize it. The release testing. This is very, very crucial stage wherein all of the software projects, right from its basics to the last, that is, right from its induction and feasibility study and analysis, design, development, coding, and all integration and finalize the software, it's about to be released, about to release to the market. In that case, how best it performs. Whether it is against the standards is also one of the measures taken into account in release testing. So if it is perfect in all respects, then it is going to be released. And the release testing is also having classifications or some subtopics that have to be dealt. I'll explain it. And these classifications are part of the release testing because we have to take into account many aspects of the complete project finalization, release test. The software is going to be released. Then once the software is released, that is not complete to the market, because that's what I told, there are some classifications in release testing. So release testing means it is about to release to the market. But whether user accepts it, that is one of the flavors or one of the classifications or one of the strategies or one of the categories under software testing, will make a user as part of the project and ask him how best it satisfies all his needs according to the specification given to earlier by him, or any time intermittently told or modified as per his needs. So whether he is ready to accept the software, user test. So these all topics are dealt in this unit 5. Testing as such, in a project phase itself, the very first topic of the software project is the cause or the need of the software. Cause or the need of the software. In the market nowadays, there are millions of software or billions of softwares. On the parallel grounds, you will find thousands of software on the parallel grounds working for the same objective. In that case, the user has to accept one of your software or the software you have developed, which you find or which it is given as an order by the end user for his requirements. So in that case, you have to think about many varieties of testing. So the testings you have to go for are of many types, because you have to struggle for existence, or you have to compete with your opponent for giving the standard software. That's why we have told in the first unit itself, the software engineering is the basics of producing a professional software, or a professional software development basics are the software engineering, isn't it? So here, once the software is ready, we'll go for testing it based on the standards or the based on the ideologies, or based in simple or down to earth, I can say, based on the requirements, whether it is satisfied or not, all the user requirements. That is the last topic in the previous slide I have told. So here the classifications we'll make for testing. Different sort of testings are there. But these all testings for every software is not necessary. That also I'll clarify. For every software, all these testings are not necessary. as and when required or based on the context of the software developed or the project or in the domain, we'll think of what type of testing required and what type of the methodology we are using in that testing and how we devise the test cases. We'll discuss about the test cases. The test cases inside the testing also we'll think about so that our software is perfect or it is more professional. The visual testing. Mostly the word itself is more implied, that is visual testing. How the software looks. How the software looks or how the user looks into the software. Visual testing. But this is not done by the end user. It is done by the system analyst or the expert system administrator or so in the high level or having a good volume of experience, good number of years of experience. He looks at the software and he thinks of one or the other points, how the software has to look and how it has to be. It's also called as software design, or it is also called as an architecture of the software, how it has to be. So visual testing means how the software has to be, whether it is based on that background or not, it has to be tested. The ready software has to be looked in based on one specific template which is in the system admin's mind or the expert's mind, so that has to be visualized. So visual testing. Specification based testing, very simple. The specs, after collecting the requirements, your unit 2, collecting the requirements, classified again functional and non-functional requirements, you have collected. So based on the collections, based on requirements, so you are going to design or finalizing based on requirements, you are going to finalize the specifications. So those specifications based test means whether it's meeting all the requirements, because requirements, why we are not checking against requirement is non-technical language. Specification is a technical language. That's why we are studying, even we have dealt in our previous classes about the UMLs and the related approaches or the phases of the software development related, the time cycles, etc. So many aspects we have studied related to technicality involved in making the software specifications. So based on the non-technical language, the technical language to develop a software, that is specification. Based on that, we test it out. We have specification printed, ready with us. Then comes the development testing, which I have just now dealt, I have told in brief. Development testing is the software under development is going to be tested in different varieties. Those varieties we'll discuss in detail. That's the reason I have postponed it. So that's called as development testing. Functional and non-functional testing. So in functionality and non-functionality, the functionality is what actually the computer has to process, what the system has to process, what the function involved, and what are the basic or the key features. Based on that, the complete software works. For the purpose the software works, or the processes involved in that software for which it works, that is the functionality. Then the non-functionality is the add-on favors or add-ons for the software or supplementing factors based on which the software has to work, or software has to be supported by those features beyond which the software is not called as a standard software or a best software. The supporting features, non-functional features. The best example is performance, efficiency, etc. Performance, efficiency, non-functional features. The functionality and the process are the equations, the mathematics, or the processes based on individual submodules. The processes involved, those are the functionality, functional, non-functional. We'll talk to these sort of testing, about these testing in detail further. Integration testing. Integration is almost like there is a project and project is divided in its different modules or workloads. The whole project is divided into 10 or 5 or whatever number of phases, or this is the first phase, or you can say module. Like that, this is, so all these modules are developed independently. These modules are developed independently. Software nowadays required very fast. So these modules are developed independently, and for each of the module we have our own, what do you say, the testing methodology, our own the professional setup for managing and finalizing the module. So in that case, once the software is ready, this whole project has to be finalized as one software. It has to be finalized software. In that case, we have to integrate it. We have to integrate it. So this integration feature, based on the hierarchy, the priority, or the requirement, or actual the flow of the work, the flow of job, or the flow of process, that is more important feature. Based on the that criteria, we have to go on adding or integrating that software or the modules to make a final version or evolution of the complete project, which is called as one finalized professional software, which you are going to release it to the market or giving it to the end user or your customer. So that is an integration. It is called as an integration. Integration is, it is the combination or joining of the individual modules to the overall product, or inducting into the overall product project. So that makes the final software ready. That is integration. Finally, the performance testing. Performance testing is mostly, as you know, it is how the software performs in number of operations per second. So operations per second is the performance mostly. It's not actually, or maybe in the industry they may treat the performance in terms of time also, means the actual time to happen all the number of processes together one time, suppose 5 seconds or 2 seconds, or total time taken by the group of process also is taken as one performance issue. But in general, I am saying it as number of operations per second. Number of operations per second is performance. So the very best performing software that you have to produce, is it so? And there are the standards, or there may be some set of operations which are time consuming that you have to mitigate, or you have to cut down its processing time, so that it becomes more faster performing software. So that is performance testing. Then alpha testing. Alpha testing is the called as a lab test. It is finalized lab test. It is for a, I can say, it is completed software, finalized lab test inside the computer laboratory, or the place where the software developed inside the lab is going to be tested. It's called as alpha test. For testing, it has got a number of test cases, and how actually the customer is going to give the inputs, all those are taken as assumptions. Some assumptions, based on the assumptions, or the test data given by the end user, or collected from the end user, it is tested inside the laboratory called as alpha testing. Once alpha testing satisfied for the good performance and the everything, the integration of all aspects or the all modules are perfect in functional and non-functional combinations, and we are satisfied by the development and based on the specifications, and it looks very professional software, then we are ready to release it to the end user. But we will not make it because we have just tested inside the laboratory. But some commercial softwares having the involvement of lakhs of finances or rupees involved, wherein we cannot directly say that the alpha testing is a final testing wherein we have developed a perfect software. Maybe it is having here or there one or the other bugs, so which has to be tested by the end user. So that is called as the beta. So you dump the software at the customer site for testing, not for releasing. You dump the software for testing at the customer site. It is at the your site or a lab site. It is at the customer site. Then test it out and check all the functionalities or all the requirements, whatever the customer he has told, according to him or according to his data, it is working fine. It is called as beta test. Finally, once customer says yes, then you are going to release it to the market, or you say that it is called as an evolution of the software. It is an evolution of the software after all the testings are over. That is after beta. Then your further job is purely a maintenance. Maintenance is either add-on software required apart from whatever you have developed or based on the requirements, additional requirements as time passes, as well as data backups for the software, because a huge amount of data gets produced every now and then and that has to be backed up, and the system has to be updated for the latest trends and technologies or the equipments involved, because today there is a 4G, tomorrow 5G or maybe 6G, or the network equipments, it was with a cable earlier, now it's wireless, maybe, who knows. So the devices or equipments or components are going to change in the market or a business domain. So based on that, you have to go for modification of your software, the same software you are going to modify. So for that, everything ultimately under the title maintenance. Got it? So that's called as updation and add-on software requirement, additional software requirement as a supplement to the existing software. So that is called as the maintenance after implementation of the software. After beta testing only, the implementation of the software takes place at the customer site for working, not beyond this. I hope the testing involved, the types of testing involved, what I have explained, and these are the as per the sequence mostly, at least this is, I believe, more than 90%, this is the correct sequence they follow in the industries. And it may, here or there, it may change in case of agile programming techniques or methodology of software development. Here or there it may change for the convenience or the mitigation of the time or reducing the time or the cost. Here or there it may change. Beyond this, it's nothing. Well, we'll go ahead for the testing with the why, the question why we have to test, where the testing has its key points or the main points where the testing is actually required. Till now we know an overview, the testing and its need from end user side, but as a software developer we also should have an idea of the end user's data, how it comes into, how it gets processed and how it goes out, and what is the reaction by the end user or for the end user, his customers involved, and there should not be any errors or erroneous results should not be produced by the software you have developed. That's the reason why testing is required. We'll study just two, three slides. The point, testing is intended to show that a program does what it is intended to and to discover program defects before it is put into use. That we have done in our previous slide. I have shown the testing methodologies. The testing process has two distinct goals. That is, demonstrate developer and the customer that software meets its requirements. That to developer, the customer, that the software meets its requirements, to discover situations in which behavioral software is incorrect, undesirable, or does not conform to its specifications. It may be some it's producing either erroneous result or the result or a report, whatever comes, is not in the format what he needs. You just have to alter the format, or the figures given in the output are not actually as per the specification. You are giving an integer output, but customer needs a decimal output. That is 1.25. Instead, you have rounded up it to 1.00. Simple example. Or 1.5, you have rounded up to two rupees and showing an integer as 2, but customer wants, or your end user wants 1.50 only, the output format. Here or there, one or the other, undesirable features here or there exist that you have to either change, alter, modify to meet his all requirements. The first goal leads to validation testing, where you expect the system to perform correctly using given set of test cases. The first goal leads to, that is the first goal of the software, why means towards testing, the very first goal leads to validation of the testing. The validation of testing, wherein you are checking the system performs as per the expectation. The second goal leads to the defects testing, where the defects are, where it is malfunctioning, where it's not performing well. It may be a designing problem, or it may be the coding problem, or any other issues related to that you have to rectify and produce the final software in a perfect way. Actually, as per the textbook, has got verification, validation, are part of the inspection process in the software during the software development. After this step, then comes testing. So this unit 5 in testing, you have verification validation also, you have testing also. Don't get confused. What do you mean by verification validation? Why the words are taken into reference, and what the testing means? Both mean the same or they are implied, but the process involved over here or here or here are a bit different. In general, or on the parallel grounds, I can say all are towards developing a best performed software or the software without any errors. But verification is different, validation is different, and testing is different in some wording or some accent, you can say, in some accent. So that we'll go through. As per the point, testing cannot demonstrate that the software is free of defects that will behave in a specified way in all the circumstances. In all the circumstances. That's true. Because there may be a problem with a network, there may be a problem with the system's speed, or there may be a problem with the customer's input. Here or there, one or the other problems will occur that we cannot guarantee that in all the circumstances the software will work perfectly. We cannot guarantee. Secondly, the ultimate goal of the verification and validation process is to establish the confidence that the software system is fit for the purpose. Is fit for the purpose. So this, that's called as, you have inspected, you have checked in the software development or during the development activity, you have checked that the software developed should be fit for the purpose, any purpose that customer might have told. Testing is part of the broader process of software verification and validation, that what I have told there, and I have classified with one title, that is called as inspection. It is concerned with checking the software being developed meets its specification and delivers the functionality expected by the people paying for the software. That's more important because they are our backbones, or we can say they are, customers are the main, what do you say, source of money for the software developer. In that case, we have to take care of them. In general, the software testing diagram given as per the textbook is in this way. That is, input the test data for the system to check the output, whether outputs which reveals the presence of defects, that is output with errors. You can see the small e. The input causing abnormal behavior. Input is also having abnormal behavior. In that case, the output is also having abnormality, that is having errors. Otherwise, input test data goes to system and the output test result comes perfectly. This is a in general diagram of the testing. The word validation and verification have very good slogans, I can say. The slogan is, are we building the right product? Are we building the right product? Means, suppose there is a messaging. You are sending message to the other party. For example, you are using WhatsApp. While building WhatsApp Messenger, before that there were several messengers. But now you have opted for WhatsApp because it has got some key features or best features that other software did not give. So, are we building the right product? Are we building the right product is the validation process by the developer. Verification. It is also by the developer. Are we building the product right? Once decided that we will develop a messenger only, but it should have the features which are different from or which are more than the what features other the messenger have. So that example, what I am giving now. So once decided we are building a messenger for the first, the second one is the product is building or the software is going to develop or it is being built correctly. That is called as the verification. The validation is the first one to finalize about an issue or the cause of software development. Once you decide over, then the verification, that is, are we building it correctly or perfectly? That is the verification. This is a simple block diagram to understand the input-output model for software testing. Well, when we have a software, we are testing it. It is being built, it's under development, or finalized software. Both In both cases, we are going to test it out. Because we have a test-driven development, and once the product is ready in our hand, there also we are having the testing. So in both the cases, when we have a testing, then what are the functionalities involved? Functionalities involved in testing. So what are the functionalities that we test? Functionalities that we test. Just we'll have a look. These are the, here I'm writing just a simple classification. The functional features, what we are going to check, either under development or finalized product. What are the non-functional features that we are going to check, either the software under development or the finalized software. The examples we can take, the business rules, the protocols. The business rules is, the simple example, if you go take a commercial software or a banking software as such, the software, say for example, for a fixed deposit or a savings bank account, there is fixed rate of interest. It has to be calculated or it has to be compounded for every 3 months. That is called as a business strategy or a business rule. That is implemented in net banking or a mobile banking or whichever banking software you take. That is whether that formality is observed, that is business rule. The transaction correction, adjustments and cancellations. Anytime during the operations, if you don't want, then you should be able to cancel the transactions or you have to delete the transactions or you have to completely wind up the transactions. In that case, is it possible? Administrative functions means for any of the software, you have the privileges of the user, creating users. But before going to that, do you have administrative privilege? Means completely you occupy or completely manage the software as an administrator or as a superior. That should be provided or that should, privileges should be there. Authentication. For each of the users, every now and then goes in, comes out, or every time he logs in or logs out, there should be a formality of this feature, that is authentication, and the respective log file should be created when he has come in, when he has gone out. So that is called as authentication. Authorization. This authentication is purely meant for security purpose. Then comes authorization levels, means who will dominate on whom or who will control the attributes of whom. That is authorization. Audit tracking.